Mr. Vice Chairman.
Thank you. Shri Praful Patel.
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chairman. The Finance Minister has delivered a very, I would say, enlightening and very knowledgeable speech of the budget. Of course, we heard it on TV since you were speaking in the other house. I won't be political or critical. I'll be only analytical. But, ma'am, I think you could have achieved much more, and the impact of your budget could have been much more meaningful and helpful to the state of the Indian economy as it is today. We agree that, I mean, that's what you let us know, and of course we cannot deny the fact that there is a global challenge in the global economy, and there could be some impact of that on our economy too. But largely, I think India has grown over the years because of the sheer size of the Indian economy, the inherent strength of the Indian economy. We are, in many ways, a very largely integrated economy, unlike most other countries. Because of our own size, the consumption patterns within our own country, the entire, whether it's the manufacturing sector, the agricultural sector, and even the services sector, we consume most of what we produce. And that is why India is unique, and we should not only be putting all the issues of the current economic crisis or the slowdown only on the global economy. We also have to look from within. The reasons why we have failed to, you know, grow, not only grow at the pace which is required, but also the reasons why we have slowed down. And in fact, on some counts, we have even reversed the pace of the growth to a negative, which I think is something which we need to really worry about. The numbers, I mean, there are so many numbers in the budget, it's no point trying to go into the numbers. But if you see what has been the past track record of the numbers which have been presented to Parliament and the actual numbers achieved, I think there has always been a huge mismatch. We deliver a budget, we say this, but actually if you go back in year after year, I don't think you will have matched most of the numbers. In fact, the expenditure also, which India is, you know, hungry to spend in terms of infrastructure, in terms of social sector programs, I don't think the government has been able to, forget the revenue side, but the expenditure side, both ways, I think there is a huge mismatch, and I think this is something which you have not been able to address even in this very long budget speech which you have delivered. The GDP also, if you are, go by the past, I mean, we have also been in government. I think ever since this government came, you all have changed even the basic, the base and the computation of the GDP numbers. And therefore, even at 4.5%, the impact of 4.5% would not be so severe as much as you are feeling it and seeing it on the ground. The 1991 crisis of then, and the way Dr. Manmohan Singh as the finance minister had dealt with that situation, and from where the Indian economy took a complete U-turn and started growing, I think we should have taken some, I'm saying not the same situation, but some kind of learning from that experience, that we needed to give some major boosters to the economy, which I unfortunately do not find much to praise you about. The industrial sector, I mean, I'm sure you have been meeting people and seeing all the numbers, but the industrial sector across the country is under tremendous pressure. I can understand some industries which have a lot of impact of the international trade, and therefore a lot of imports coming in, which could put pressure on the domestic economy by industry. But at the same time, where that is also not the case, I do not understand why Indian industry is not being given the helping hand which it requires. The auto sector, I have also been in a part of the government where I was associated with the auto sector. It is completely, I would say, it's in disarray. most manufacturers, today you are only looking at the slowdown. You are also discounting the fact that India as a growing economy would be putting in so much more investment into the automobile sector, which eventually would help the Indian economy in the future. The complete investment in the auto sector has stopped. I do not see any major company trying to put in new investment or in trying to see that, you know, they can prepare for the future. Of course, BS4, BS6, these are all temporary phenomena. But the real issue is that the entire auto sector is reeling under the impact of lesser money in the hands of individuals, because they are actually the backbone. They are the people who buy and consume most of these two-wheelers and four-wheelers. And that is something which you need to worry about, because the automobile sector accounts for a large part of the manufacturing economy, the GDP, and that also results in huge employment numbers, which are seeing a great amount of stress and slowdown. The industrial sector also is really under pressure, because there is no financing available today. We banks are flush with money. You all give numbers which are very, you know, rosy in terms of, oh, this much is credit is available, that is available. But actually, bankers are not disbursing money. I don't know for what fear, for what other reasons, but industry today is facing a severe liquidity crunch on account of financing. That also needs to be really addressed. I would dare ask you a question. That is there any industry across the country, from north to south to east to west, where there's a 5,000 crore investment which is being put up today? I think that is something which you should really think about, reminisce. I'm not putting this poser out of the blue. It is a fact. Can you count one industry which is being set up in the whole of India which has a capital investment of about 5,000 crores? The answer will be no. In any sector, all that you are seeing is stressed assets which were incomplete are being sought to be bought over by some other company are being completed. But when you talk of new investment in industry, I do not find a single new industry coming up in the country which leaves us to really think and to try to correct that situation, which would be very, very important. Even in infrastructure, the road program is a very talked about program, rightly so. Can you just think of the kind of the private sector participation in roads? You will not find anybody. All you're doing is you have the money in the budget thanks to the fund which you have created because of the meltdown in the global crude prices, and therefore you created a fund. You kept the prices in India artificially high, and you created the fund for which most of the roads are being built today. But there is no private sector participation in roads. That is also another reason. When there's so much of growing volume of traffic, when roads as such, BOT basis, could have been made into a very attractive infrastructure investment, I don't find many companies, not even a single company, in fact, is coming into creating such kind of major infrastructure projects. So this is also something which we have to factor as something for immediate correction. The agricultural sector, we talk about agriculture being the backbone of the Indian economy. Yes, of course it is, because a large number of people, it may not be big in terms of percentage, it's only about 15% of the GDP, but the impact, because 65% of people still live in villages, largely depend on agriculture. And the agricultural growth, whatever we talk about, I would say minus the 2, 3, 4 major producing states like Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh, most of India today is not seeing agriculture growth commensurate to the kind of investment which we are talking about, the kind of support which the government claims that it is giving to agriculture. Yes, you may have brought in the Krishi Sanman Yojana by giving 6,000 rupees to the farmer, but I think that is too little and too less, which in fact does not really incentivize the farmer. It's just giving him some support. But I think the real change which is required in agriculture, another green revolution which is to be ushered in agriculture, is sadly missing. We don't find much initiative on that front. Of course, there have been isolated pockets of where agriculture has shown tremendous growth and change in the crop patterns. But largely in India, the crop patterns and the kind of agricultural produce which needs to be supported, I don't find that any initiative in the budget. Few minutes, sir. The social sector schemes also are, on one side you've given fancy numbers, but I don't find that the social sector schemes are being supported much by the central government. I can give you even instances of MNREGA, where I can give you the name of the district, or you can check Gondia or Bhandara district in Maharashtra, and find out whether the MNREGA workers have been paid for the last 1 year or so. They have not been paid. It's not something, and please do not talk of the local government of the day, because the government has only changed 3 months back. You can check figures even going back beyond the earlier 3 months and find out how much of MNREGA payments have been made or how many are outstanding. So this is all, it's very nice to present a budget in Parliament, but on the ground, what is actually happening? Even Ayushman Bharat, the very, I would say, a good scheme which has been promoted by the government, but how much of it is actually benefiting the people is something which you need to say. One note, Mr. Disinvestment target of 2 lakh crores, very ambitious. This year, what was your target? Previous year, what was your target? And how much have you achieved? And 2 lakh crores, simply by saying that, I've got an LIC coming up on the block and therefore I will be able to generate this big number. I think it's more an eyewash than actually what is actually going to be achieved. The banks, the NBFCs, the crisis which you have seen, banks are being sought to be further capitalized, good thing. But how much has actually happened? How much of your mergers of banks or capitalization, recapitalization helped? Today, banks, and you know so many banks, I'm not only talking of public sector banks, but private sector banks, NBFCs, have so much of public money at stake. What is being done about the weak private banks? What is being done about the NBFCs across the country? We only talk of a couple of NBFCs here and there, and which have like ILFS or DHFL, but there are hundreds of such major NBFCs across the country, where millions of common people's money is invested and they are at huge risk. Even some of the private sector banks, I won't name anybody, but you can look at the kind of the financial health of those banks, and immediate corrective action, if not taken, can again create many PMC banks in the future.
Please conclude.
These are a few of the things. Yeah. Make in India, very noble initiative. How much of that has happened in defense? How much of money has come in the Make in India program? I think we need to hear from the finance minister about how much investment has come on that. Construction and real estate. Well, the largest investment and the largest employment provider in the country is the construction industry. How much of a slowdown is it witnessing? And even those few steps which you have announced in your budget, are they really going to be giving you the benefit of giving a higher economic activity? And last one.
We've gone way
exports here. Have declined year on year in the last 5 years. And how much is being done to reinvigorate the export economy of our country? And finally, the GST. We've all talked of GST as something very important, very good, no issues. We've all supported it. But today, states are not getting their money which is due on account of GST. Months of backlog, the amounts of backlog, how are the states which the only source of revenue going to sustain is something which the finance minister really needs to look at. With these few words, although I could have spoken on every issue much at length, I think the finance minister needs to, and she still has an opportunity in the coming weeks after the parliament reconvenes when the finance bill will be passed, to come up with some novel ideas and to correct all the missed opportunities which she could have availed of during her budget speech. Thank you.
Sri Manoj Kumar Jha.
Thank you so much.